First and foremost, let's see how this fucking heroic race is doing. Well, actually, first and foremost, hello everybody. Yeah. So, the topic of tonight, while we are still breeding some dragons, just like in the tutorial that I just posted 1.5-2 days ago. Terra and Flame. You can also do Terra with Terra. It doesn't matter. It just needs to take just a little time. So, well, actually the topic of tonight is professional Dragon City player. What is a professional Dragon City player? I will ask you what is a professional Dragon City player. You can say this in the comments if you really wish to share your opinion. But why? Ah, so we got one now. Nice. This is what I was talking about. So, back to the professional Dragon City player. Where this came up from? From a post that I had. From a comment, actually, that I had on Facebook when I posted the tutorial about how to advance faster in the heroic races. And this is the comment that I was talking about, and it reads like this: it's all about luck, plus your league is easy and you are at lap 7. Pros are at lap 15, dude. So don't accept to crush your opponents when you have a really hard race. So, first, it's all about luck. Actually, in your mind, my friend. Because in my mind, luck has nothing to do with knowledge. And then here, pros are at lap 15, so don't maybe expect to crush your opponents when you have a really... Okay, this I can understand. But, first, why it's not about luck? Well, when I made this video, I was at lap 7 just because I wasn't applying anything that I said in this fucking video. Okay, so from 2 days ago when I was lap 7, I don't remember which node, now I'm already at lap 9. It's past 1.5 days since I posted and since I started also applying that knowledge. Anyway, the funny part is with the pros. This I cannot understand, because what does make a pro a pro? Well, I don't see any pros in this game. If you talk to me about I don't know, other games like World of Warcraft, StarCraft, I don't know, Counter-Strike, where they participate in tournaments and they get money for playing and they train every day. And yes, but the difference between amateurs and professionals in my vocabulary is that they get paid in one way or another by playing this game. So I don't think there is any professional player in this game. I really doubt that someone makes money just by playing the game. Others are probably making some money playing the game by posting YouTube videos and making money out of these videos. Yeah. By the way, I'm not making any fucking money out of this. So yeah, I'm not a professional. Although I'm playing every fucking day. Yeah. Don't worry about the sound outside. I'm not a professional also at YouTubing. Yeah. So, yeah. This is almost about it. What I wanted to say tonight about being a professional, because to me it was very, very funny to say something like this. But people start to complain before doing anything. Anyway, so I'm really curious to hear your opinion on this professional shit. I'm expecting, of course, any opinion on the comments, if you feel like it. So, in the meantime, at some point I wanted to, let's say, show this guy, even though I'm not a professional, this strategy works, and from lap 7 to reach lap 12 to get the Hinokleos dragon, but I decided not to do it just because I will have to spend a high portion of my gems, and I decided that my gems are better spent on expanding to another island, which I have 2 days or 10 hours left until then, and some small slots here to buy, and then go to the other island, because with the discount you can buy this next island with only 80, with only 85 gems. So yeah, this is what I decided, and until next time, I hope you really enjoy this game, and if you also enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Otherwise, you know what to do. Until next time, have fun and enjoy your dragons.